Hey, space friends, this week I'm talking about diatoms. Diatoms are these magnificent jewels of nature that I featured at the beginning of my recent TED Talk. If you haven't had a chance to check it out yet, definitely go check that out. There's a link to it in the YouTube description below. There's so many awesome things about diatoms that I couldn't fit into my TED Talk, so I wanted to do a separate video about them. Diatoms were one of the absolute delights that divers and underwater robots would collect for me while I was in Antarctica. I absolutely loved looking at them all under the microscope. They would be embedded in the seafloor and in the sea ice ceiling. You can find diatoms all over the world, wherever there is water, be it salty or fresh or gloopy water. You don't have to go all the way to Antarctica, although a lot of them do like chilling out near Antarctica. They like the cold, but you can find diatoms pretty much anywhere on Earth where there's water. Diatoms can proliferate pretty quickly, kind of like rabbits, so long as there's silicon dioxide around for them to build their glass houses with. Given that silicon dioxide is two of the most abundant elements on Earth's crust, and that it comes from a mineral that's pretty darn abundant on Earth, quartz, then, well, diatoms are able to kind of just live the good life. They're living their best lives because there's silicon dioxide around nearly everywhere, which is pretty good for them. And they've really been crushing it, especially for the last 100 million years. I also mean that literally because, well, because diatoms have glass houses, their houses don't decompose. So even though they die, their corpses sink to the depths of the oceans and then build up over the years, millions of years. So you have kind of these corpses crushing each other over millions of years, and it actually creates something called diatom ooze, which sounds kind of gross, but essentially it's all these millions of years of microscopic organisms dying and then crushing each other and then becoming their own deep sea sediment very deep into the earth, which is kind of cool to think about. Diatoms are only between 5 to 200 microns in size generally. A micron is 1/1000th of a millimeter, so diatoms are actually incredibly tiny on an individual scale. But within their small size, there's 100,000 species of diatoms. There's so many different types of diatoms, and they come in all sorts of shapes, and that's really what's so delightful about them. They come in stars and oblongs and triangles and all sorts of shapes and sizes, which is just amazing. I love diatoms so much that my mom actually recently got me this huge makeup book of diatoms that I love. I actually recently featured it on Adam Savage's Tested as one of my favorite things for the year. And it just shows the diversity of diatoms and just how much there is to know about them, which is a lot. I even love how we refer to the structure of diatoms, because each diatom has a girdle. Yeah, a girdle. And that girdle holds together two valves, and it really showcases the beauty of the structure of diatoms themselves. Some diatoms even have spines that stick out from them that help them sort of glide around. And some diatoms are able to glide around and move themselves using their own locomotion, while other diatoms prefer to just go with the flow. They can't move themselves, but they kind of just go with whatever is happening. So I guess they're a little bit more chill. But there's so many interesting things about diatoms. Even in the ones that don't move, the thing that's really fascinating if you find a diatom that's still alive is you can see little bubbles inside of it dancing around. Those little bubbles are actually its food in the form of oil droplets. Back in the 1800s, people were so inspired by diatoms, and why wouldn't they be? But they were so inspired by them that they actually created designs and arrays of diatoms in these geometric, beautiful pieces of artwork that you could only see with a microscope. They would painstakingly put together a bunch of different diatoms into these beautiful arrays and have the microscope slide itself be its own form of art. Today, it's thought that there's only one person left who still keeps up this art form of arranging diatoms on microscopic slides to produce beautiful pieces of artwork. His name is Klaus Kemp, and he spent 8 years just perfecting the perfect glue to embed the diatoms in on a microscopic slide. Diatoms are absolutely amazing, but we really don't know about what their future looks like when it comes to climate change. Some diatoms might do really well with climate change, while others might die out. If we know anything, it's that there's a good likelihood that the diversity of diatoms might disappear, that we might only have a few left. And that's what's really sad to me, because the beauty of diatoms is just the amazing diversity in them. Thanks so much for tuning in this week, space friends. As always, I will put links in the YouTube description below about the topic I've talked about today. And also, there's a shout out to some of the really awesome patrons who are helping me create videos like this one. If you want to help me create videos like this one, I really appreciate it. Head on over to my Patreon campaign and you can also get some cool stuff. Otherwise, I will see you all next week, and remember to always be exploring.